Thanks for your company right across the country. Our top story today, Queensland police are defending their actions this morning after shooting a man north of Brisbane.
Today, Queensland reporter Andrea Crothers joins us from the scene at Bray Park. Andrea, the man allegedly threatened officers.
Yeah, police say that they used the minimum force necessary, James, in this particular circumstance. But that will all form part of this ethical standards probe into what went wrong, why police fired those shots. Now, we understand officers were originally called to this Bray Park home in Brisbane's north side yesterday afternoon after reports of a domestic incident between 45-year-old Brett James and a 37-year-old woman. When officers arrived, they alleged that he then tried to stab them. That's when they fired those three shots. Officers performed CPR at the scene before James was taken to hospital. He remains there in a critical but stable condition.
Andrea, thank you.
We have breaking news on an emergency unfolding in the Atlantic Ocean. A tourist submersible used to explore the wreckage of the Titanic has gone missing with a crew on board. As we go to air, a desperate search is underway. The vessel was last seen 600 kilometres off the shore of Newfoundland. On board is believed to be a number of crew and British billionaire Hamish Harding. We'll be crossing live to the United States with all of the details on this unfolding story in the next 10 minutes.
The government is celebrating the passage of the Voice to Parliament legislation this morning, with the Prime Minister expected to be at the forefront of the Yes movement. Let's go live to federal politics reporter Eliza Edwards. Eliza, when will Aussies get their say?
Sarah, the date for the national poll is still yet to be set, but it's expected sometime in October. Yesterday, the final hurdle in Parliament was cleared, with legislation sailing through the Senate to set up the referendum. The question will ask whether Indigenous Australians should be recognised in our constitution, with an independent body set up to advise the Parliament.
Voice is a powerful word, and it's up to us to listen to that voice.
It is the right thing to do, President, and it is time now to put this question to the Australian people.
Advocates will now try to regain some of the momentum following a slide in support for the voice, while the no side will be ramping up its campaign too. The winning side will need to convince a majority of people in a majority of states. Sarah.
Thanks, Liza.
The newlyweds at the heart of the tragic Hunter Valley bus crash, which claimed the lives of 10 people, have broken their silence for the first time. Mitchell and Madeline thanked the community for their love and support as they request privacy. The local football club, who lost several members on board the bus, also spoke on their grief.
Our community has experienced unfathomable heartache, distress, sadness after a number of people closely connected to the club were on board and either injured or killed. And we will lean on each other through this incredible and difficult time with the memory of everyone that has been lost at the forefront of our thoughts.
The groom's father is now calling for mandatory seatbelts on buses. The maximum penalty for carrying a knife in public or in a school is set to double with new legislation to be introduced to New South Wales. Offenders could face 4 years in prison and could be hit with a $4,400 fine. Terrifying dash cam has captured the moment a Tesla swerves out of control on a freeway in South Australia. Cars were forced to pull over before the car on the wrong side of the road slammed into a barricade, narrowly missing other drivers. Police are now investigating if the driver suffered a medical episode. A Sudanese refugee has pleaded guilty to a Melbourne crash that killed his best friend. Shocking footage emerged of the moment learner driver Emmanuel Kerr speeds down the Westgate Bridge at 120 kilometres an hour, over four times the legal alcohol limit, and smashes into a truck. Kerr is expected to be sentenced in October. A 26-year-old Brisbane man is recovering this morning after he spent two nights lost in Lamington National Park. Rory Lane was bushwalking with a friend when they got separated. He sustained serious spinal injuries from falling off a 5-metre cliff. He was airlifted to hospital and is now in a stable condition.
Well, millions of Aussies are shivering through an icy winter blast as another cold front descends on the east coast. Today, reporter Isabella Staszkowski joins us from Melbourne. Isa, it's a little chilly.
It certainly is. James, good morning to you. It is in fact bitterly cold right across Australia this morning, and those freezing temperatures are really being felt here in Victoria, in Tasmania, the ACT and in New South Wales. It is all because of a freezing air mass that those temperatures are really plummeting. It's also our second cold front in just 2 days, so expect conditions to be wet and to be windy. Here in Melbourne at the moment it is just 5 degrees, but the feels like is more like 3 degrees. I have seen one gentleman running past us though wearing shorts, so very brave from him. Yesterday was our coldest day of the year so far, and tomorrow it's going to be so cold that we could even see some record-breaking temperatures. So look, this is what people wanted to really kick off the ski season, but my goodness me, it is going to pack a punch.
I love those gloves, Isa. Thank you.
New South Wales could lose its prestigious AAA credit rating, with the Treasurer warning rising debt is hurting the budget. Treasury analysis shows the state will be paying more than 5% of its income on servicing debt within the next 2 weeks. It comes as the state government delays a proposed tax rise on Star Entertainment Group. Medibank has fallen victim to another cybersecurity breach by a Russian gang 8 months after their first massive data breach. The country's biggest health insurer confirmed it is a customer of US file transfer service MoveIt, which was broken into. An investigation is underway, with Medibank saying it has applied security patches. A man has died following an altercation with transit guards at Perth's underground train station. Nine News understands 24-year-old Josh, who lived with a disability, became extremely aggressive and attempted to hit one of the officers. He suffered a medical episode within a minute of being handcuffed before being rushed to hospital, but could not be saved.
I really feel like the system has failed Josh and the family at every level. Really, we need to have answers right now about how Josh was failed and who Josh was failed by.
The circumstances of his death are still to be determined. A new study has found Australians with cancer who caught COVID-19 were kept safe during the pandemic thanks to vaccines. 600 cancer patients took part in the study, which found 1 in 10 patients died within 100 days of infection, but vaccines and antivirals protected many from deteriorating. Jetstar has announced it is adding new routes from Brisbane Airport to destinations in Asia, while also increasing the number of flights. The new services, which are part of a deal with the airport, are scheduled for Tokyo, Osaka and Seoul beginning later this year. Flights will also increase on routes to Bali and Auckland. All right, let's get a look at the markets for you now. On Wall Street, the Dow Jones is down and the S&P 500 is also in the red. At home, the All Ords closed up yesterday. In London, the FTSE ended down. Commodities and gold is at $1,900 an ounce, and oil is at $76 a barrel. Now, this next story, it's very concerning. Okay, you ready for this? The humble meat pie, an Australian delicacy, has seen a dip in popularity.
What? Get your act together, people.
Yes, in 2020 and 2021, we couldn't get enough of them, spending $180 million on pies every 3 months throughout the height of lockdowns.
That's a lot.
But I'm sorry to say that's changed drastically. Our spending on the Aussie icon has dropped by 40%. So I think we all chip in and get a dog's eye for lunch, guys. It's the right thing to do.
I mean, they obviously didn't survey us. We've got our intake has increased.
Yeah. I reckon I'm having a pie a week.
Pies are the best meal on earth.
It's convenient.
Well, they're eating these with a fork. What's going on there?
Well, that's part.
How about our EP who eats them upside down?
What?
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah, Kendall.
What?
Not cool, mate.